So 343 just released this blog, another blog this week, about Halo Infinite Forge beta Q&A. Michael Score, who is the leader, or sure, I should say, the head of 343's Forge, recently hit up Twitter to kind of ask what you guys have any questions about. And well, this is the blog. I thought I'd go through this and give you the quick TLDR of everything they mentioned within this blog update. The first question asked is, will 343 be adding community maps into matchmaking regularly, and how easy slash difficult would it be? And they kind of give a complicated answer, but it's actually kind of warranted, because they're saying like, well, we can do it, yeah, and then we plan on doing it for sure, but depending on what the people make and what, you know, meets our quality of standards, saying our quality and stuff like that, all variables there. But it sounds like something they would be willing to do, but might not be something that'd be super fast. I wouldn't expect it the same month of November for it to be coming out anytime soon. They did say that they do have plans for a Forge playlist that highlights only community created content. Probably nothing before the end of the year, my guess. Probably early next year, we might see something like this, maybe within the March update. We'll have to wait and see. Then we had a confirmation about new maps coming into the game beyond just the pit. We know it's coming in. They stated that it's gonna be coming in before the end of this year. That's the goal, at least what they stated. But they also said throughout next year, really important thing, that other official legacy map remakes are planned further down the road. This could tie in with our streamy friend Unique, who got a unique DM from community manager Unishack.
Guys, I just got a Twitter message from Unishack, a DM. He wants to talk Halo stuff. But I told you guys, if this was gonna happen, I'd most likely have to go under NDA. If you guys don't know what an NDA is, it's a non-disclosure agreement, meaning the stuff he tells me, I would not be able to tell anybody. NDA'd out of his mind.
So literally, he's making a remake of Guardian, and then 343 employee goes, hey, I want to talk some Halo with you. I'm just saying, we could see some Guardian coming in. Another bit of rumors going around that Narrows might be joining in with that group of some official legacy maps tied in along with the Pit and Guardian. But again, as soon as we get that information officially, I'll let you guys know here on the channel. The question of, while you're releasing as a beta, when will you be out of beta? Is it based on performance, content, or what? And they say that's probably more based off of bug and polish fixing that we could see with this. Now, it could be similar to what we have with like Halo multiplayer launch beta, that was more like the launch of the game and not necessarily a beta. I would assume that most of the time this is probably gonna be much like the official launch of Forge. When like it goes out of beta, I think people probably will be playing it plenty of time by then. I mean, by season 3's launch, they still state it's gonna be in beta form then as well. So I'm assuming all throughout 2023, it's gonna be a lot of Forge beta we'll be hearing until maybe like the end of the year. They were asked about importing geometry from things like Maya or Blender into Forge, and they basically gave the long answer of saying, well, that would be nice, but there are some community guidelines we need to follow. We're gonna take a note from the MCC monument approach to see if we can do something like that, but nothing planned anytime soon. Now, I covered this previously on the channel months ago when the Forge beta leak first kind of came around, and showed that like they had like the Pack-a-Punch from Call of Duty imported into Halo. That would be really awesome to have, but it sounds like there probably be issues with copyright issues and also just content being like modified content on a console to be implemented properly, because it's such a closed ecosystem. Maybe we might be able to see it on PC, but no guarantees anytime soon. Now, this Forge looks amazing, but it might be a little complicated, especially for myself who has been out of the Forge game since like Halo 3. It looks kind of complicated. Will there be any kind of tutorials with this? And they said no, but you can go into different community hubs like Halo Waypoint, Forge Hub, and the Scriptors Guild when it comes to finding good information. I do plan on making content about like tutorials on how to forge in general. I actually am in talks with Infinite Forges, who, if you guys haven't seen him around, definitely need to subscribe to him for some good Forge content. He'll kind of like show me the ropes and how to forge as a noob, so I think it'd be a fun video for you guys to check out. This is a big one. I know I've been wanting this for years now, and they said, is it possible to add campaign AI into Forge? Short answer, yes, which is really cool. They say that with the AI scripting that they've mentioned previously on the Forge blogs and stuff like that, that really does a lot of the heavy lifting when it comes to implementing campaign AI into Forge. And they do state that they are kind of working on it, though it is kind of a long road ahead to actually get that to happen. But they said that it is possible, and they know that people want it, and it looks like they're looking to try to pursue that creation, which is Oh my god, that would be amazing to get some campaign AI in the Forge. Traditionally with Halo, when it comes to like a file share, right? You've been able to have it on your profile. You're able to, you know, have like a map or a mode that you like. They can download it from you. It sounds like that's not going to happen, as they sit here saying, can I download maps from other people? And they kind of did like the roundabout way of saying like, well, there is the recommended menu. It can also go to searching specific things within the Forge menus, like coming with November 8th. But it sounds like from player to player downloads, not so much. So far what we've seen when it comes to Forge content, it's a lot of Forerunner stuff and a lot of UNSC stuff. But what about the Covenant? And what about the Banished? Well, they did state here in the blog that they are looking to add those types of materials into Forge as well, but right now they're looking to finalize all the Covenant stuff, and then maybe had like Flood, Covenant, Banished kind of materials in there, which would be fantastic. Now, a really cool thing they also mentioned is saying you make a custom power up, and yeah, you can with the scripting that's when Halo Infinite's Forge, you can pretty much tie it to whatever you want it to do, so that's really awesome to see. They also answer the question about, okay, when Forge leaves beta eventually, will all the content that you create in the Forge beta carry over to the full release? And they said yes. Now, one environment that's actually really missing from the current setup when it comes to the maps available for Forge is something with water. There really isn't anything with water or blank canvas with water. They answer the question, do you plan to add water features at some point? And they did say they're looking to bring in placeable water, but no plans or details right now at the moment. According to leaked information, though, that's very credible from what we've seen, most of it's actually come true, that there is a Forge Ocean map that's kind of similar to like Tidal from Halo 5's Forge list coming into Halo Infinite. So I think that would probably suffice for the lack of a water map right now. Instead of having the placeable water, you could have just a map that's made of water. But again, there's two different things that definitely you could utilize placeable water in certain situations. But right now, it looks like that is probably in the works, but not anytime soon. Now, there's been a wave of information from 343 in the past week. So if you guys want to catch up with stuff, here's some videos right here that will keep you up to date that's happened with Halo. Obviously, I do plan to release everything you need to know about the winter update here in November on Monday. So see you guys there. Thank you much for watching. Catch you on the next one. Peace out.